I'm Dr. Singh from Toa Payoh Vets. Today is August 10, 2017. I'm creating an educational video to teach vets and owners how to handle a dwarf hamster for examination. Now we have a case here. This dwarf hamster comes in for consultation. As you can see, the owner already warned that it will bite. So don't use a hand, and then it get bitten. So to examine this hamster, most owners they hold it in their hands. So when they hold it in their hands, then the hamster sometimes slipped and fall and then run to the table and then fall down to the floor, and they die because of injuries, internal injuries. So now the best way to handle the hamster is to wear a thick glove. And in this way, you can hold the hamster with the glove, but sometimes can bite through also. So hold the hamster well, and then put as near to the high container as possible, and quickly transfer over to here. So if you transfer to here, then the hamster is unlikely to jump off because it's quite high. Now, preferably get the bigger container than this. Then when you examine the hamster, you examine inside the container, so that you don't have problem of hamster jumping off onto the table and onto the floor. Now you look at this hamster, you can see, you can hold it by the scruff of the neck. You got the scruff, the skin there behind the ears. It's called the scruff of the neck here. Here, this is the scruff of the neck. The scruff of the neck, and then you check. The complaint is a big tumor here. So, as you can see, this is the subcutaneous tumor, and the other complaint is the sense gland a bit dirty, so we have to do this too. We have to operate to remove this the subcutaneous tumor, which is causing irritation and bleeding inside. Then after we remove this and then we clean the sense gland, this has to be done under anesthesia, then the hamster goes home. So put it inside the high container so that it doesn't have a chance to jump off here. And then some of them are very fast. So when they jump off here, before the owner can say hello, the hamster would run off and then drop onto the floor and die of injury. So never hold the hamster in your bare hands, because sometimes it might bite and then you just react to it by letting go. So when you let go, the hamster will just run off. Now this hamster I hold in my bare hands, but it's only for demonstration only. I just demonstrate, but never hold like this with the bare hand, because it might bite you, you see. And if you want to hold it with the bare hands, then you hold it inside the high walled container, so that it won't fall outside on the table. It will just fall back in. So that is the end of how to restrain a dwarf hamster at the vet. Okay, finish.